Israel's war cabinet has reviewed military plans, vowing that it will extract a price for Iran's unprecedented missile and drone attack. The United States is still attempting to de-escalate the situation through diplomatic channels. But there are now fears Iran's nuclear sites could be targeted, with independent inspections temporarily suspended due to safety concerns.
A vocal display of Iranian anger, hardline supporters shouting death to Israel after Iran's unprecedented retaliatory strike. The escalating tensions felt in Jerusalem, where shops have reopened, but school is still cancelled.
It definitely feels like we're dealing with a bigger enemy, I'd say.
Israel's war cabinet is vowing to respond despite threats from Iran. Its next move would be more serious.
Iran will face the consequences for its actions. We will choose our response accordingly.
So what could an Israeli response look like? One option, and the one pushed by leaders in the region, is patience, holding off on a major retaliation and targeting Iran's proxies such as Hezbollah in southern Lebanon. That has been ongoing, including this bombing just yesterday. Its second option, an attack on Iran itself. This could see strikes on the military bases that launched the missile attack or the command control of Iran's powerful Revolutionary Guards. There are also concerns over a strike on Iran's nuclear sites that Israel has long claimed were being used to try to build nuclear weapons. Any of these would risk significant retaliation.
We are urging that they shouldn't escalate.
Iran's nuclear operations were suspended on Sunday due to security concerns, with the world's nuclear watchdog halting inspections until tomorrow as leaders attempt a diplomatic solution.
The United States is committed to Israel's security.
But the US won't be drawn on exactly how involved it would be if open war between Israel and Iran breaks out.
Don't want to speak to any hypotheticals. We are committed to Israel's defense, and we showed that over the weekend, but we want to achieve de-escalation.
Ursula Hager for 10 News First.